What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Ross the Boss coming at you with an all-new Let's Play Europa Universalis 4. Austria is picking some of the dumbest fights. They are attacking into the mountains, and they have a -1 terrain penalty. That is absolute suicide, even if they have a superior force. We now have 40% war score. We could possibly get a separate piece, but you know what? I'm going to take the separate piece only because we're losing money. And if we look into our coalition map mode, a lot of the aggressive expansion has died down drastically. At least I hope so. Would have been nice to wipe out a few of those units, but that is fine. These units can move here. These units can be disbanded. These units can move here. Where are the rest of my fleets? The Ivory Coast will need to make their way back down. I'm sure a lot of my troops my fleets have been destroyed. The Cape of Good Hope. Well, we don't need these units here. And this heavy doesn't need to be here either. The Cape of Good Hope. All right, we are going to send our troops back down. Gaining some ducats, which is nice to see. Okay, you can go to Zanzibar. Gaining 7.16 ducats. You're already moving to the Ivory Coast, and you are moving to Zanzibar. Do we have any rebel factions? It looks like we do. Thank you, Austria, and thank you, Tuscany, for all of your assistance. We are going to improve relations with both of you. And I am most likely going to declare war on Tunisia. Unfortunately, we can't do so for the next 5 years. They don't seem to have any allies, but that'll be fine, and that will be okay. What about Mali? If we declare war on Katsina, we'll bring in Mali and Yao. So I think what we'll do is we'll declare war on Mali, and we will declare war on Yao. Where are the rest of my troops? These 18,000 are doing fine. These 18,000 need to be moved. You all can retract here as much as possible. To Dore, I could go ahead and declare war on you, but I don't believe I will. We really need manpower more than discipline. And obviously we are losing money. So our best option would be to retire both of these units and try to get our income back up higher. We have 270,000 troops. That is quite a bit. And we are cruel, which I don't like either. We're unable to request any type of assistance. And we do have some loans, only one though, which isn't too bad. Did we get a master recruiter? We did, but he is a level 2 advisor. I don't think I like that. Let's wait until we get a rank 1 master recruiter. We have a free colonist and we have a free merchant. We are going to send the merchant over to Malacca. That way, we don't have much income, but we'll be able to send 24% of this trade power down to Zanzibar. Okay, the rest of these units need to be repaired. All of you can be upgraded and mothballed, trying to save a little bit of money. Still don't have our master recruiter. At least that's not what it looks like. We can move back up to speed 3. We're going to need to produce a lot more ships. A royal marriage for Austria. We now have a very powerful queen consort. It might be in our best interest, though. I would like to get rid of our heir. I will obviously side with the nobility, but their influence is very high as it is. If I side with the clergy, the nobility will hate me. That'll be fine. And of course, we have even less manpower now. Okay, this is exactly what we want, but it's in the wrong spot. Let's go ahead and just buy it anyway. Well, I'm trying to save money too. We'll retire him just in case. We obviously have more military power than we need. And we have 8 generals. I don't think we need this admiral. So we will retire you. But I am going to leave the rest of my generals only because they will die, of course, in time. Unless we have anybody so weak and pathetic. A 1-2. Very weak and pathetic. We'll find you. No leader. Dismissed. And now we're only losing 2 military power instead of 4 every single month. We do have a lot of corruption due to our unbalanced research. Do we have enough for a master recruiter? Still do not have one. When the year 1735 comes around, we're going to attack Mali, we're going to attack Yao, and we're probably going to attack Tunisia as well. We are going to want to improve relations with Ethiopia. Trade efficiency, nice to see. Okay, do we have all of these units? Can be any damage. Boost you up to 50. These units, if they take any damage at all, may need to be repaired. Bring you up to 50. How is the Ivory Coast looking? I don't see any ships here at all. Oh, that is because they're being repaired up here. And these 12 ships can be built into heavy frigates. Protect trade in Genoa. And hopefully in time, Timbuktu will become mine. And we still don't have our master recruiter. Austria is asking for assistance. Scandinavia, the Commonwealth. Ay, ay, ay. We can obviously win, but who is Austria allied to? Okay. So let's see this war. France and Bohemia. I'm going to accept just in case, only because, you know, I'd love to put some even more hurt on France. All of our vassals should be helping out as well. I have 2 lightships here for some reason. We are going to send you to protect trade in Genoa. Okay, these units can make their way down to Mali. These units can make their way down to Katsina. These units can make their way down to Tunisia. And in 4 years, we're going to have 2 separate wars. Actually, 3 separate wars against Tunisia, Yao, and Mali. Do we have any transport ships? I don't believe we do. We'll need to create those as soon as possible. And once again, we don't seem to have any money or income. Let's reduce our army maintenance for the time being. And I really want to get rid of this commandant. And you know what? I think I am going to disband a few more generals. I'll leave 5 because one is bound to die in the next 50 turns. Tierra Austria is about to be... Austral is about to be able to send us some gold, which could be very nice indeed. We don't need land force limit modifiers. We need more manpower. If we go to our religion map mode, I could reduce the discipline and try to improve our production efficiency, giving us more income. Probably a lot more income. An empress consort of the people. Because our king is cruel, we are going to want this. That was very expensive as well. And it looks like Provence is on our side, dealing quite a bit of damage. And we are going to want to go ahead and create our 24 ships. We're going to want two of those. We will have you meet up in Galicia. Actually, we'll have you meet up inside Lisboa. 24 ships being produced. It's going to take 646 days. I think that is a risk we are willing to take. I could, of course, declare war on Brunei. They have a lot of aggressive expansion, but a lot less than what we were dealing with before. I obviously want to be able to quell all of these smaller nations. And I think we'll do that next. Once again, we are going to have to deal with some uprisings. On the 1st of December, we will go ahead and deal with whatever we can. I don't even have people here. So we'll deal with the unrest for now, for the next 10 years. We have speed of 3. Once our truce ends in August of 1735, we are going to absolutely wipe out all of Tunisia. Give it to Djerid here. And once that happens, looks like we are a defensive planner. Once we give all of this to Djerid, we are going to have more Protestant nations, or more Protestant territory. We are slowly taking over Timbuktu. We can embrace new technology, but we're so far behind in debt, I'm not sure that we want to do that either. How are the rest of these territories looking towards embracing the Enlightenment? Not until 1779. And you will be able to embrace... 1987, that is a very long time. Ooh, I could have one stability or 1,000 ducats. I really want the stability. And we have two entire loans to pay off. This is costing us 12 ducats every single month. We might want... looks like we're being attacked inside England. I wasn't expecting that. We'll obviously put them down. They have a very powerful general, a 453. Hopefully we can attack them soon, but I'm not sure how well this will work in our favor. We're going to take out these smaller troops. We do have some generals here. And we are attacking into the farmlands against the superior force. Even though we have more discipline, they have more morale. We are going to need to retreat. And hopefully funnel over some additional troops. But unfortunately, we don't have any troops to spare. They're all in provinces that they don't need to be in, like this island. And before we decide to take over more territory in Majafatit, if I can pronounce that correctly, we're going to, we have so many troops over here as it is. That's one of our biggest priorities, is moving them. Okay, these units need to move up to Lisboa, at least as quickly as they can. Adding any type of general will improve their maneuver. These units can move over to Mali. And it looks like we have... I want both of these 36,000 troops over here, but for the time being, we'll maneuver some. And we are going to camp out inside the woods and inside the marsh. Ragusa has now been given a separate piece. We never did get our master recruiter. It looks like Bohemia has made their way all the way over to Provence. I could go ahead, unmothball these ships, and essentially go ahead and take out, oh my goodness, 101 ships. That is very dangerous. I think I'm going to make Galicia my alt, actually possibly Algarve, my biggest naval production facility. So having local ship repair time would be a high priority. Or, of course, I could put it on this province. Eh, we'll see what happens. Okay, how close until my troops are in Tangiers? We already have 24 ships. Exactly what we need. 15 two-deckers, though they do have a little bit more on the enemy side. All of these trade ships can make their way up, produce about 50 heavies, or excuse me, heavy frigates at least. Looks like we've lost all of our trade ships here inside Gibraltar and inside Sevilla, so we'll need to make more of those. How many ships do we currently have? 295 out of 327. We are currently producing 71. Secrets in our alliance. We're about to send over another 18,000 troops. Hopefully it'll make a difference. We're going to have 48,000 troops. They're going to have 48,000 troops. They do have far superior generals. One of our generals did not die, which is fine. We have a 2-5. He is our most powerful. We're going to wait until they attack us. But they do have more morale, which is dangerous as well. We would attack in, we will cross a river. I don't know if I would like that. And I would really like military technology level 26, but we are nowhere near being able to embrace the Enlightenment. This is going to cost us 9,681 ducats. A new settlement, we obviously want the base tax. This is a grasslands province. We'll do something like this for the time being. Continue to take over more provinces. Or maybe even something like this. We now have the ability to get engineer cores, though I don't think we're going to do that. Do we have any other units that could make their way up? Ah, we're about to be attacked. And just like that, Scandinavia is going to get a -1 crossing penalty. And it looks like they're going to crush me. Are we going to make it in time? Most likely not. 27th of May. They just have a far superior force, which is probably our biggest concern. We really need more troops. And then the rest is up to us. These 24 units can move to Traarza. and we're gonna die. Yay. No way we can get out. 23rd of June versus 17th of June. Is there any way we can retreat? Not until the 5th of July. These units are dead. And just like that, my transport ships are nowhere to be found. These heavies can block the port here, so they aren't able to, or block the strait. Am I anywhere near my master recruiter? Once again, don't have one. We'll try again on the 1st. Land maintenance modifier is going to be nice, so I think we'll get that instead. Saving us about 11 ducats every month, giving us from positive 3 to positive 40. Okay, we are about to be attacked by 102 heavies, or excuse me, 18 heavies. Might as well retreat where we can. 27th of August. Loan from Lubeck. We don't really need that. Our grand shipyard is about to be completed. These 18 ships can make their way up. And we might even go ahead and try to produce another 18,000 units. It is going to take a long time. Our best bet would be to take over Ayrshire and probably a few other provinces as well. Or we could create 18,000 troops, have them meet up in 97 days, and then funnel over some even more troops when we can. These 12 transports don't need to be here. We will disband them. They are costing us income, and they don't need to be. And now that Scandinavia is going away, you can move into Ayrshire, you can move into Ayrshire. We now have quite an abundance of troops in Ayrshire. These units can now meet up in Santigny and try to get a few more troops. All right, well, thank you all so much for joining me. I will see you in our next adventure.